Today we are going to create a snowflake painting using watercolor and a little gouache. The watercolor I'm using is Shinhan Pro watercolors. I normally use a professional quality paint. The paper I'm using today is from Master's Touch by Hobby Lobby. It's a medium quality paper. And then I'm using Royal and Langnickel brushes, although I'm not too picky about brushes and use a variety. The first thing I want to do is get one of the pieces of paper. These, I believe, are 8 inches by 8 inches. And I am taping all of the edges around the outside onto a board that I can pick up and move around. And the reason I do this is to give a nice crisp white border to my finished painting. And then I will be moving my board up and down and leaning it and tilting it, and that way the paper won't move. And it also helps prevent the paper from rippling when I have lots of water on it. I'm gonna start with a flat brush, or mine is actually slightly angled, but a larger flat brush works well, and I'm just gonna cover my entire paper completely with water. I want it to get pretty wet so that the paint will just kind of move all over in the paper. So I'm really trying to make sure that every section of the paper is filled with paint, I mean with water, and then I will add the paint to that water in a minute. So you can kind of see from the glare of the light that everything looks like it's nice and wet. And I am gonna go ahead and start adding in some paint. Now, the only color I'm using for this project is Prussian blue. I love Prussian blue. It is such a beautiful color. There's like a slight tint of green in it, and it's nice and dark and rich. So I'm right now just trying to dab some paint, and you can see because the paper is wet, it starts to kind of spread out into that water. And by lifting my board and moving it around, I can help the spread of the paint. Now I'll also add a little more water on my brush too if the paint is not moving enough. And I'm trying not to just do lots of brush strokes, but just kind of dropping some paint in and then instead just moving it around with my board. Leaning it, tilting it this way and that. It just makes for a more interesting effect. And it's super fun to watch too. I don't know, there's always something so calming and mesmerizing about watching the paint just kind of spread out in the water. Now I kind of like the fact that there are some darks and lights in this. It just makes it for like a more dynamic picture. So I'm gonna really try not to like even it all out too much. I do wanna cover the lights a little so that the white snowflakes stand out, but I do want areas of lighter sections and areas of darker sections. So I'm gonna maybe try to push the darks just a little bit more, especially kind of around the edges and in the corners by adding a little bit more paint. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm taking a little bit of white gouache, and I have it on my smaller brush, and I'm just hitting it against my other brush to create these little specks of white on my picture. You can see the effect, and these will kind of bleed out into the background color as well, but it'll kind of give this like snowy effect, and we'll go back in and add a little bit more detail later. So I'm doing that just all over my picture. It's just white gouache. And you could try it with white watercolor. It just may not show up quite as well. Gouache is a little bit more opaque and will show up on a darker background. So I dip my brush in some white gouache and then I tap it on my other brush to get these little specks of white all over my picture here. It's really also a fun step. I always enjoy doing this as well. The last thing I'm going to do is I have a little bit of table salt, and this is optional. I'm not even going to cover my entire area. I'm just kind of going to stick it in a couple places towards the center, and I'm not going to do a ton of it. Sometimes I go all out with the salt, but today I'm just going to sprinkle a little bit in a couple sections, and the salt kind of sucks up the water. You can see this is the gouache I'll be using for my snowflakes, but you can see the effects of the salt here. Where it kind of sucked up the water and left those like really interesting patterns in the painting. So I've got my white gouache again, and I have it on my small brush, and now I'm going to start drawing snowflakes. So everything is dry on my background. It's important to wait until the background is dry, because otherwise this would just bleed into the wet background. Now I'm going to start with a vertical line, and then I add an X, trying to make it kind of through the center of my vertical line for this snowflake. And then I'm going to go ahead and add another line to complete my X. And I'm just using white gouache. You could also use white acrylic paint, like the little craft paint for this step, and that would totally work as well. So if you don't have gouache, it's not something that you've purchased, you could totally use acrylic paint and you would get the same effect. You just want something that's opaque, that's not transparent, so that it'll cover up over your dark blue background. So for the snowflakes, you can add little details like little dots on the ends. I do a lot of different things to create snowflakes, and there's so many different things that you can do to make them fun. I added little V's, I'm adding little dots in the center. So just anything to kind of make them look pretty and delicate. This is also great exercise in practicing like your line work with watercolor. And I find it to be somewhat meditative too, just sitting here working on various snowflakes. All right, I'm gonna add another one. I'm gonna do this one a little bit higher up. Again, I'm starting with a nice straight vertical line and then adding the X just like I did on the last one. Making sure I have enough gouache on my paintbrush so that I have opaque lines, meaning you cannot see through them. And I'm going to do a different design on this snowflake. So I started with the X. Now I'm going to add lines in between my other lines, like so. And then I'm going to put V's on the outside edges, maybe two on each stem of the snowflake. And I'm trying to keep them about the same size. And just working my way around. Adding a couple little extra dots. And voila, I have another snowflake. I'm going to continue to do this around my picture until I feel like it is full enough. It has enough snowflakes to fill the paper. Just kind of taking my time, playing with all the different shapes. And if you need more snowflake drawing ideas, you can always look it up on Google. I just typed in how to draw a snowflake or snowflake patterns or snowflake designs, and there's tons of them, and some of them are quite intricate, and you could sit there and work for a good 30 minutes on just one snowflake. But I am just using very basic ones just to try to keep it simple. Most of them just have like the six sections and then the V shape added to the stems, just in a different variety of patterns. But this is definitely a calming exercise. It's great if you're feeling stressed to kind of help you relax on a busy day. And it doesn't take super long. I think my entire painting took me about 20 minutes or so. That does not include dry time, though. All right. Here's another one I've started. Again, just with a vertical line and the X. And then I just think of other things I can add. I'm doing fatter Vs on this one. And just three on each stem. So I'm pushing down a little harder with my brush so I don't have such skinny lines. I thought it would be nice to add just some smaller, less detailed snowflakes. So for these ones, I'm just doing a cross and then an X, just to kind of be little fillers in some of the empty spaces. So nothing too fancy or intricate, just an indication that there's some that are a little bit farther away too. You can't quite see all the patterns. You can also do this by adding some dots. Kind of going back into some of my spots and adding a couple little just dots of snow too, little sparkles of white. Thought it'd be nice to add an indication of a snowflake off the edge too. So I hope you enjoyed painting this with me today. It is such a fun and relaxing painting. And again, can just be so meditative. So give it a try and tell me what you think. Did you enjoy painting the snow as much as I did? And I hope you enjoy thinking about the beautiful snow as it falls from the sky. Please visit me again soon. I've got all kinds of tutorials on my channel, Ilky Art. And thank you guys so much for watching. We'll see you next time.